All right, keeping on with. Keep those cards and letters coming in, Steph.
Chapter 8.
Chapter 8 of 1 Corinthians. When something right is wrong, and what he's saying is liberty. Take care with your liberty. There's a lot of stuff we're free to do as believers, but we're not free to do it. Now, concerning things sacrificed to idols, we know that we have knowledge. Knowledge makes arrogant, but love edifies. If anyone supposes that he knows anything, he has not yet known as he ought to know. Huh?
Yeah, there's another one of those.
If anyone supposes that he knows anything, he has not yet known as he ought to know. But if anyone loves God, he is known by him, by God.
Our knowledge is foolish.
Oh yeah.
But we know that.
To not know, and know you, how does that go? To know, to not know, and know you don't know, is wisdom. To know and not know that you know is something else. But to not know, but not know that you don't know, that's foolishness. I don't know it, but I talk like I do. So I really don't understand that I don't know.
Peter Russell.
Well,
kind of.
Yeah, that's where they end up. Everybody understands. How many of you have heard that Peter principle thing? That's to be promoted to your level of incompetence. They promote you. You do a good job. They promote you. Do a good job. They promote you. You're out of your world. You've been promoted to your Peter principle. To your Peter principle. And that's the people you have to work for. They don't know what they're doing, but they got the position. Concerning the eating of things sacrificed to idols, we know that there is no such thing as an idol in the world, and that there is no God but one. For even if there are so-called gods, notice that's little gods, whether in heaven or on earth, as indeed there are many gods and many lords, but for those lowercase, yet as for us, there is but one God, the Father, from whom we are all things, and we exist for him, and one Lord, Jesus Christ, by whom are all things, and we exist through him. Huh?
That's in verse 5, it said, there may be several gods both in heaven and on earth. I know there's a God in heaven, but so-called gods both in heaven.
That rock. Would that be more like to the mythology gods, Mercury and all of them that they classified up there that oversaw the people down below, like in Athens and everything?
Then remember, he's writing to people, to these Greek people who created all of those gods.
That's a good point. I like that. Face it. Got it.
I've heard a lot about the Greeks.
That's the only thing that could be.
Because the people believed that they were gods up in the sky.
Yeah,
but they weren't.
But they believed they could come down and
Do stuff, yeah.
Do stuff with humans.
They were scared to death of Mars.
Because, was he fire or fast? No, Mercury's fast.
Yeah.
with Mars.
That's.
I thought they'd have been more afraid of Zeus. He was thunder and lightning, wasn't he?
I'm talking about the planet Mars.
I thought you were talking about the god Mars.
Oh.
Huh. Verse 7, chapter 8. However, not all men have this knowledge, but some, being accustomed to the idol until now, the people who had worshipped false gods have come to Christ, come to Yahweh, eat food as if it were sacrificed to an idol, and their conscience, being weak, is defiled. The food, the meat, whatever that was sacrificed to that idol is polluted, if you will. It is deified to them. And they eat it because the free Christians are eating it, but they're concerned about it. The thing that we can compare, that I can compare it to, is alcohol. Alcohol is not forbidden. Paul tells Timothy, drink a glass of wine a day. Drunkenness is forbidden, just like gluttony. You don't hear much preaching about gluttony, do you? Especially big fat preachers. Don't look at me in that tone of voice.
I remember as a Methodist minister, I went to church in West Virginia where I went to. We had a hot dog cook at the time. He ate 21 hot dogs. Now that's gluttony.
That's gluttony.
His son ate 15 or 16, I can't remember, and he got sick and ate 21 hot dogs. That's what he said, wiping him sick. I don't know.
You know, they said, you say, a preacher's leather belt was a leather fence around a chicken graveyard. And if the preacher's crossing the creek and lost his false teeth, the way to get it, tie a chicken leg onto a string and drag it through the creek. But he's talking about people who once worshiped idols. They have trouble eating the food that was sacrificed to animals, to the idols. Verse 8, but food will not commend us to God. We are neither the worse if we do not eat, nor the better if we do eat. But take care. Verse 9 is where we lose our freedom. But take care that this liberty of yours does not somehow become a stumbling block to the weak. That's why I say a drink of alcohol is not forbidden. But if we influence a weaker person who gets hung up on alcohol and becomes a drunkard, then we bear part of the burden. Our freedom has led to somebody else's. And I think it's reactions to that that sort of led to our teetotalers. Nobody should drink because you might lead somebody astray. But as far as the, you look at a bottle of Listerine. How much of it is alcohol?
97%?
No, I think I saw 25%.
NyQuil,
that is.
Yeah.
I remember a guy that taught at me in college, I taught at, looked at the Listerine. Golly, and I spit it out.
I get to swallow it.
For if someone sees you, who have knowledge, dining in an idol's temple, will not his conscience, if he is weak, be strengthened to eat things sacrificed to idols? For through your knowledge, he who is weak is ruined, the brother for whose sake Christ died. And so, by sinning against the brother and wounding their conscience when it is weak, you sin against Christ. Therefore, if food causes my brother to stumble, I will never eat meat again, so that I will not cause my brother to stumble. Now you take that to extremes. Remember going to a restaurant and the waitress asked us if we wanted some water. The guy with us said, never touch the stuff. Water is dangerous sometimes. We went out to Oklahoma. My brother-in-law was in college out there. They don't have real good water out in that part of the world. Jeff was, I don't know, 10, 12 years old. And that night in the motel, he was seeing bugs crawl all over the place. I mean, we took him down to a little hospital and they said, must have got something from the water.
Wow.
So,
but they say don't drink the water in Mexico.
Don't drink the water. Tequila.
Yes. Same thing is true in Russia. That's where I learned to drink water at room temperature. It's, you drank bottled water in Russia. That they did. And refrigeration was a treat. It's up in cold was a treat over there. Coca-Cola, any of the soft drinks. Room temperature. Of course, in the wintertime, the so room temperature is good.
You said it that side.
But what he's saying there is there are people who come from something that bothers them. I'm in the Emmaus walk. We have a girl from India. She was a believer in India. And the way our Emmaus behaves and dresses is sort of the same way that her persecutors in India behaved and dressed. And it bothered her. And she had memories of being in trouble at home. By the same way we were acting here. Did we change? We assured her that we didn't learn from them, that this is corruption, and we understood and would not make fun of her for not participating. But you never know where somebody has come from. That's why they say so much today we talk about God as Father. So many people in our society today don't have good images of fathers. So, we're responsible for folks. Even though we have the freedom, we have to be careful that we don't cause a weak brother or sister astray, to feel left out, because we have a habit of making strange comments that would make them feel they don't fit. I'm going to eat my steak whether you like it or not. You know? There are those of us that have that attitude.
Me.
They put the, try to put the I and we. Okay, next time we'll pick up at chapter 9, dealing with submit to the authority of the Bible. Study it.